Thursday Murder Club came about. My mum lives in a retirement village in England where everyone is over 70. So it's a community full of older people. And when I went down to visit her, it's very beautiful. Lots of green fields, lakes, you can hear the birds singing, very peaceful, very British. And I thought to myself, this would be a wonderful place for a murder. And as I started speaking to the people who live there, and they're all over 70, and you hear about their life experiences and the things that they've done, I suddenly thought, well, if there was a murder here, I bet you would solve it. And that's where the Thursday Murder Club came about. It's four people, all in their 70s, all very different. One was a former spy, one was a nurse, one was a psychiatrist, and one was a labor activist. And once a week, they meet up to look over unsolved crimes. You know, they have a glass of wine, look over old police cases, and then suddenly there's a murder on their doorstep. And that essentially is where the Thursday Murder Club begins. You've got these four friends, unlikely friends, all in their 70s, who essentially are thrown into a series of murders over a series of books. And it's sort of telling the story of people who are in their 70s, who we tend to overlook, I think, and we underestimate. And they get this new lease of life and these new friendships, and they do extraordinary things, and they outwit the police, and they can interview whoever they want. And so they're sort of classic Agatha Christie murder mystery stories, but with this amazing cast of heroes, all of whom are in their 70s. It's been lovely that the books have been huge in the UK and in America and places. So I thought it's very British, the book, so I thought no one in the rest of the world would like it. But I think the books, firstly, they're quite like Agatha Christie. They remind people around the world of Agatha Christie. They make you laugh, they make you cry, they've got mysteries at the heart of them. So it's been lovely for me to be successful outside of the UK, so to be successful in Japan and Brazil. However, I need to be more successful in France, because France has the best taste in books. France has the best taste in literature, and I haven't sold enough books here yet. And you will love these books, France. I absolutely guarantee it, I promise you. You know, the rest of the world has taken to them, so I need France to come on board. There's going to be a film adaptation of the book. Steven Spielberg bought the rights to the book before it was even published, actually. They're making a film, and people always ask if I want to get involved or if I should write the script, and I think Steven Spielberg knows more about films than I do. And I don't want him to do something and me to ring him up and go, Steve, what's this rubbish? I trust Steven Spielberg implicitly. He made E.T. and I didn't make E.T. So I'm as excited about everyone else. I'm as excited as anyone else about the book, because I want to see what they're going to do with it. But hopefully filming this year, so hopefully next year it'll be out all around the world. It's fascinating. When before the first book was published, you sort of send them out to television companies and film companies just to see if anyone's interested. And in the UK there was lots of interest because people know me, so I sort of expected that. But yes, someone had obviously sent one to Amblin, which is Spielberg's company, and literally within 2 days they'd got in touch and just said, look, we love this story, we love these characters, we think, you know, this is universal, we think this could play around the world, we love the idea of these heroes all in their 70s, we love the crime. And so, yeah, that was a fun phone call to take. And so, yeah, various people offered to do the TV adaptation, but as soon as Steven Spielberg came in, we had to say to everyone, I'm so sorry, we're going to have to give it to Spielberg. I'm currently writing the third book in the series, so the first two are out in France at the moment, and the third one will be out in the UK in September. France, it'll be a little bit later because of translation and what have you. But yeah, this is going to be an ongoing series. I've definitely signed up to do four, but the way they're going, I'm very happy to keep doing them. So yeah, I want to do them for, you know, 20, 30 years if I can do. That's the plan. I'm going to write other things as well, but there's always going to be Thursday Murder Club books. It's been such a pleasure being here in Lyon and meeting French readers. It's the first time, because when I wrote this book, we had the pandemic. I couldn't come anywhere. So I'd be doing Zooms and things like that, which I love to be with people. And meeting French readers, it's been such an absolute treat. And now I've done it in Lyon. I want to go around the rest of France and meet everyone else as well. It's so lovely just to sort of chat person to person and hear what people think of the books. And I'm going to be spending a lot of time in France in the next few years. In Bordeaux for sure. If I'm invited to Bordeaux, I'm going to come to Bordeaux.